Day because this is the day we learn everything you wanted to know about sewing. So we've already had the tour of the sewing machine, which was in episode 2. So today we're actually going to use the sewing machine and do some actual stitches. I'll show you how, because all sewing machines are basically the same, have the same basic functions, and we'll go through that. But I do want to go through some general tips on starting sewing. Number one is you're going to need a large workspace. One of the most important things you want is a nice table, and it's going to be sturdy, it's going to be close to an electrical outlet, and you're going to want space for your iron and your ironing board, and also close to an electrical outlet. So once you have all these things set up, then the next step is to clean your workspace. Clean your table and actually clean the floor too, because there's nothing worse than sewing something great and you're taking it to the ironing board and you drop it on the floor and the floor is dirty. So yeah, make sure your entire workspace is clean. This will just save you a lot of trouble, because trust me, I've ruined some projects by not adhering to these basic rules. So I do want to make a note on preparation for a jingle dress. I am going to be making my 5th jingle dress throughout this video series. And I do want to say that when it comes to making regalia, it can be quite overwhelming if you consider the cost of all the materials that you need. But what I want to say is make sure you get these things over time and don't be overwhelmed by the cost. For instance, here is a bag of jingles. I got this at my local craft store on Nipissing Reserve. And this was $16.95 for a bag of 100. You want at least 300 to 400 jingles for an adult. Of course, not nearly as many for a little girl. And I will post in my link in my comment section about a company that sells colored jingles. They come in pink and purple and turquoise and red and beautiful colors. So that link will be in the comment section of this video. Acquire your materials slowly. And if you see a sale on ribbon, I would suggest that you just go ahead and buy ribbon, because ribbon is an essential commodity when it comes to all regalia, especially good quality satin ribbon. And a final note before we get on to discussing tools is, when it comes to repairing the cones and repairing ribbon, one essential tool is actually a good quality candle. Yes, a candle for finishing ribbons, and you know, a candle holder. Me, I usually use a safety emergency candle on a simple glass plate. So make sure you have a candle available for future episodes, and I will fill you in on that later. So let's get busy and let's get sewing. So we are now set up to start sewing. I have everything plugged in, my sewing machine is on. There's an on switch at the back, my foot pedal's down there, and I have all my equipment. I have my tomato and pins, I have my box of bobbins, I have my seam ripper, I have my sewing gauge, my 2 pieces of learning fabric, my fabric-only scissors, and I also have a retractable measuring tape. Now, if you look here on your sewing machine, they have fractions that are in imperial measurements. 5/8 is a standard, you know, a seam allowance, meaning that that's how much fabric is, that's where your stitches are going to go. They're going to go 5/8 of an inch from the edge. So I'm going to pin this together, because we're going to just do a straight seam. We're just going to do, we're going to pin it, lay it flat, right sides together, because the right side is what you want showing. So the right side is usually the brilliant color, and then the back side is usually a muted, you know, a muted portion of the fabric. So I'm just going to pin these together
and then I will show you how to make a straight stitch. And there's, I would say, it's my experience that pinning, a decent pinning job will make your life so much easier. So I put them together at least, you know, 1 inch every 2 inches. They don't have to be perfect. They just have to hold your fabric together for the duration of your sewing. All right, now we have a close-up. So here is our pinned test material. You can use anything. And again, the right sides are together. Those are the brilliant color. And you're always going to sew wrong sides out. So let's just put this under here. We're going to, there's an exaggerated line, a bolded line for 5/8. So we're just going to put that there. We're going to put it right about here. And this is where your reverse comes in handy. From this machine, this is the reverse button. Now it's very important to finish seams, and I will explain the reason later, but it's very important that you finish your seams so that your project does not come apart when you actually wash it. So hold that button down and your machine goes in reverse. If it goes over a little bit, that's not a big deal. So we're just bombing along, you know, keeping this along this 5/8 seam allowance, and we're just gently going. You don't need to go at really high speed, and there's little feet inside the machine that guide at a certain speed and feeds the material along. So you're going to backstitch here too. Doesn't matter if it's totally perfect. Then you're going to lift your presser feet, pull this out, and there's that handy dandy cutter I was telling you about in the earlier episode. So there we have our first seam. It doesn't matter what thread you use for the first one. Take your needles out, stick them back in. Try to keep track of all your needles, especially if you have kids and pets running around, or if you just tend to be a klutz like me. It's just a safety issue to keep all your pins together. So there we have our first seam. Now, you'll see, when we lay this out, there's our seam. Now we want to take an iron and we want to press this flat. But this is not just good enough just to do it like this. We have to finish these edges or they will come apart. And that's very important that you finish edges. There's a couple ways you can finish edges. One is by pinking shears. I don't actually have pinking shears, but they're usually around $50. And there are the scissors that cut a zigzag edge. And they're really, really nice to have. I just don't have a pair. So what we're going to do is we're going to fold it like this, and we're going to finish this seam. And this is important because if you wash this, these threads will all come apart and it's not good. So let's switch to a zigzag. And let's see here. I'm going to change it to, this is your thread spacer here. How many stitches. And we're going to do the same thing. We're going to do the back stitch or reverse. So we're going to go back. Oops. Actually, that needs to be wider. We're just going to go along the seam right to the edge. That way, when we wash our project, it's not going to come apart. When you get to the end, again, backstitch. And then you can end. Lift your presser foot, pull it out a bit. Put it through the cutter. So remember, there's a cutter on the back of your sewing machine. I didn't actually know this until 5 years into sewing. And you're going to do the same to the other seam that's on the inside. Nobody will see it, but it's important that you finish all of your seams. So again, backstitch. And then forward against the whole machine. lift your presser foot, take it out, cut it. So there we have a zigzag stitch on our seam. Now you're gonna see all these little threads. You're gonna trim them off, and then I'm gonna show you how to press. This is there, you've done your first basic seam, and this is the seam that you're gonna use for all of your sewing. Okay, so now we have finished our first seam. It's not ironed yet. We have all these little tassels, these little, you know, but once we press this, this is a really, really nice seam. I've used red to illustrate where the thread is so you can see it. But if this were an actual regalia piece, I would be using yellow so that you can hardly tell. And that when you press it open, you'll see yellow seams there. And you won't see the red thread. But I've used red thread today to show you how these seams need to be finished. So now I'm going to change camera angles and I'm going to show you how to press this. Turn your machine off, keep your area nice and tidy, and let's get on to ironing. Okay, so here we have our basic iron setup. I have water in my iron, it's plugged in. Pay close attention to the dials. This is cotton broadcloth, so I'm going to use probably the highest setting. And you will have in your manual, it's going to tell you what settings to use for what. So you're going to lay your seam open. Doesn't matter about the threads yet. I have my pressing cloth on the bottom. And really, I'm going to fold this over and use it for a pressing cloth on the top too. Because there's water in there, it's going to process the steam. And there's usually a button if you want steam or not. There, I didn't turn the steam off. So become familiar with your iron and the settings. Because this is 100% cotton, I can use a fairly high setting and just press it open nicely. A lot of irons too will have this button here, which shoots out water as you're sewing to help get the your surface flat. I'm going to turn it up a bit more though. Like I said, 100% cotton will allow you to have a really nice seam and use a high heat setting. So it doesn't have to be perfect, just press that seam flat. And then when you have your good side here, what you have is a really nice seam. Now, if this was a satin, I would say use a pressing cloth on top of that. And there you go, you have your seam. It's nice and finished, it's nice and flat, and now you can use this to, you know, join other pieces and finish your product. Yes, folks, there we have it. Really nice seam. Take your scissors and cut these off after. But your seam is really nice. You have distilled water. Make sure you know where your kids and your pets and everybody is. Most irons have an auto shut off, but please be mindful of safety and tell everybody, hey, I'm ironing, I go do something or whatever. But yeah, there's your beautiful seam. Yeah. So give lots of time for your iron to cool off. I would say at least 20 minutes to half an hour for your irons to cool off, no matter if they have auto shut off or not. And always be mindful, the safety thing, of all your cords. And move about slowly and deliberately around your workspace so there's no accidents. I have seen accidents. I've had accidents. I've burnt myself. So, I've burnt myself many, many times. So there we go. We have our first finished seam, and now you are ready to, you know, continue designing and continue with your beadwork. And just practice seams until you can do them with confidence. On this slide, we have a picture of ARYA'S hair ties. And in the next episode, we're going to learn how to do various styles of edging.
Here is a completed one with one style of edging that includes ribbons and white deer hide backing. So I really hope you enjoyed this episode of ARYA'S KOKUM, an introduction to sewing. And we look forward to seeing you next time, where the topic will be edging and beading. Have a great week.